first time, perhaps because of their affection for the newly ordained priest saying Mass, or out of curiosity for a blast from the past to see what this is all about. We come here in different emotional states, some rejoicing for the birth of a child, and others mourning the loss of a loved one. Some of us are perhaps so well versed in Latin that we can follow without a book, and others don't know Latin at all and let themselves be spoken to by the actions which speak louder than words. It's beautiful that we can all participate in this one act of worship, coming from these various different backgrounds, these different circumstances. And this illustrates that this Mass is Catholic, a word that means universal. That there is something here for everyone, no matter where we come from, no matter who we are. I hope that you'll excuse the briefness of my remarks on this hot day. I just want to share one reflection from Dom Gregory Dix, one of the great liturgical scholars of the last century. In speaking of why we come to Mass, he points out that ultimately the reason that we are all here is the command of our Lord Jesus Christ, "Do this in memory of me." Those words spoken in the upper room at the Last Supper, those words precepts after the words of consecration as he is genuflecting to the Blessed Sacrament before he elevates the chalice. It's these words that draw us here. Gregory Dix says this: "Do this in memory of me. Was ever another command so obeyed? For century after century, spreading slowly to every continent and country, and among every race on earth, this action has been done in every conceivable human circumstance, for every conceivable human need, from infancy and before it, to extreme old age and after it. From the pinnacles of earthly greatness, to the refuge of fugitives in the caves and dens of the earth. Men have found no better thing to do than this for kings at their crowning, and for criminals on their way to the scaffold, for armies in triumph, or for a bride and bridegroom in the little country church, for the proclamation of a dogma, or for a good crop of wheat, for the wisdom of the parliament of a mighty nation, or for a sick old woman afraid to die, for a schoolboy sitting in examination, or for Columbus setting out to discover America, for the famine of whole provinces, or for the soul of a dead lover. In thankfulness because my father did not die at the moment, for a village headman much tempted to return to superstition because the yams had failed, because the Turk was at the gates of Vienna, for the repentance of Margaret, for the settlement of a strike, for a son for a barren woman, for Captain so-and-so, wounded and prisoner of war, while the lions roared in nearby amphitheater, on the beach at Dunkirk, while the hiss of scythes and the thick June grass came faintly through the church windows. Tremulously, by an old monk on the 50th anniversary of his vows, furtively, by an exiled bishop who had hewn timber all day in a prison camp, gorgeously, with the canonization of St. Joan of Arc. One could fill many pages with the reasons why men have done this, and not tell a hundredth part of them. And best of all, week by week and month by month, on 100,000 successive Sundays, faithfully, unfailingly, across all the parishes of Christendom, the pastors have done this just to make the plebs sanctae, the holy common people of God. So we add one more on Sunday to that 100,000 succession. As we gather as God's people, imploring the graces that we need, whether we be weak and in need of courage, or so bold as to be arrogant and need that humility that would make our righteousness greater than that of the scribes and Pharisees. Whatever our needs, whoever we are, God gives us his grace here in the Mass. And so let us pray for ourselves, for our needs, for those who are in our hearts, and for all those gathered here, that God continue to bless us, bless this Latin Mass community on their 20th anniversary, and bless all the Christian people here at the Diocese of Rochester.